Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera. Today we will continue our lesson, which is on chapter 4. Topic is transient heat conduction. Transient heat conduction. Before we start, what is actually transient? Okay, transient is actually the thing that we calculate, which is depend on time. Last time on our topic, which is steady state conduction, right? Steady state conduction. Last time we calculate something, or we analyze something, or we analyze some model which has some heat transfer in them. There's no involvement of time. But today we will calculate something, or we will calculate, or we will analyze a model or system which is based on time. That is why we go with transient heat conduction. Okay, let's go with the first objective, or the objective of this lesson. The first one, we will go to assess when the spatial variation of temperature is negligible and temperature varies nearly uniform with time, making the simplified lump system analysis applicable. Okay, the first objective is to analyze the spatial variation of temperature. For example, you have one model. That model or that body have a variation of temperature on it. Dia tak macam dulu kita belajar on the plain wall. All the plain wall has the same temperature. For example, dinding belakang saya ni ada temperature lebih kurang 37 degree Celsius. But today lesson, the wall itself will have a variation of temperature. Okay. And the second objective is to obtain using analytical solution for transient one-dimensional conduction problem in rectangular, cylinder, spherical geometries using a method of separation variable. And the third one is to solve the transient conduction problem in large medium using similarity variable and predict them using a variation of temperature with time and distance from exposed surface. Okay, there's only three objectives we will cover on this transient heat conduction topic. On the last one, which is construct solution for multi-dimensional transient conduction, we will not cover. Same goes with the previous topic where multi-dimensional we not cover. We only cover on one single dimension. Okay, one dimension only. Let's go with this third slide of today. Lump system analysis. Okay, the lump system analysis. Let's say we have two bodies or two model here. The one is copper bar, the other one is roast beef. Okay. Copper bar, usually they have some evenly distributed temperature on it. Okay, kalau you found something that copper ball is small enough, if you measure the surface is 70 degrees Celsius, high probability that the core of the copper ball itself is 70 degrees Celsius. It is different from roast beef. Kalau roast beef, for example, at the surface ataupun the skin of the roast beef around 110 degrees Celsius, just like in the picture, but the inside of the roast beef probably is not even 110. It may around 40 degrees Celsius. This is actual happen in a real world. That is why when you cook something, for example, you cook fish, your pan around 100 or 120 or 180 degrees Celsius, right? Then you put the oil there, then the oil is hot enough to fry your fish. Then you masukkan fish dalam pan tu. Why you keep on flip the fish? Because you want the fish fried in evenly, right? Sebab apa? Sebab the meat itself, the meat of the fish is not like a copper ball. Bila you panaskan dia punya skin, bukannya tiba-tiba dia punya dalam pun akan panas sekali. Tak. Kalau meat, sama ada lembu punya meat, fish ataupun chicken, dia ada gradually temperature yang dia akan terima. Dan dia bergantung dengan masa. That's why we study on transient heat conduction today. Okay. So what is lump system analysis? So lump system is considered as a copper ball. We can consider it the whole system has a similar ataupun even distributed temperature. Kalau once you punya copper ball tu pada degree Celsius of 100, so we can say inside of the copper ball itself is 100 degrees Celsius. So that system, that copper ball, we call it as a lump system. Kalau macam roast beef, we cannot consider it as a lump system. Sama juga dengan badan kita. Kalau kita ukur temperature dalam badan kita, we cannot get what the similar temperature dekat surface of our skin. Our body is not a lump system. Fish is not a lump system. But copper ball, we can say it is a lump system if it the copper ball is small enough. Kalau copper ball tu besar, tak semestinya. For example, you ada copper ball sebesar rumah. Kalau you measure dekat outside surface temperature dia, sebagai contoh, ialah 50 degree Celsius, doesn't mean that the core of the copper ball that big enough of your house, dalam dia sama 50 degree Celsius. Tak semestinya. Okay. But the small enough of copper ball, you can say that it is a lump system. So apa menariknya tentang lump system? Lump system, we can easily use a simplified formula. Okay. You can use a simplified formula. This is the formula after derivation of some formula from basic of this geometrical parameter formula, where our solid body have a mass, volume, density and initial temperature. So when our body having a convection, which is this formula, so we try to balance them with this formula. I hope that you can see my cursor there. If not, I try to convert it to laser point here. Yep. They try to balance it with convection, and this is our properties, temperature. Then try to balance them. Then immediately they find or they derive the final formula for transient heat conduction, which is depend on time. This is the formula. Okay, this is the formula where T, where the current temperature, minus T infinity referring to environment temperature, then Ti is the initial temperature, where T infinity at the bottom there for denominator is for environment temperature, then equal to E is for epsilon there, and the minus B and the T is the second, time in second, lowercase t here, lowercase t is the time. So what is B? B is here, the total load of here. H referring to heat constant of outside temperature. AS referring to solid body surface temperature area, and divided by density of the solid body and volume of the solid body and the CP of the solid body. So that this B is the time constant, because the unit itself is 1 over second. Okay, time constant. B is the time constant. The unit is 1 over second ataupun second min, power of minus 1. So why, as I said that, we ataupun engineer try to discover of lump system, because if the problem ataupun some a real problem having a same distributed temperature around the surface and around the core of the surface atau the core of the one model, we can easily use this transient formula for conduction. Okay, at any minute or any second, we just plug in the temperature, initial temperature, environment temperature, and putting all the constant and the time at which time, so we can get the temperature of that model of that bodies. Okay, we can get that. It depend on time. For example, I have a ball of copper ball of a copper ball of temperature 100 degrees Celsius. So the initial temperature of the copper ball is 100 degrees Celsius, and the environment temperature of the copper ball is around 5 degrees Celsius, which is colder than usual. Then I plug in all the formulas, all the constant there, and the time itself. The time itself, I put in the time. For example, I want what happened to the tap of the copper ball after 5 seconds. I put in letter T, lowercase t here as a 5 second. Saya plug in semua all the constant. Saya akan dapat T function temperature in the function of time, berapa value of temperature selepas 5 second. So this is transient heat conduction formula for lump system. Lump system. Okay, apa maksud lump system? Saya beritahu tadi, satu model ataupun satu bodies, kita consider them as fully distributed ataupun evenly distributed around the surface, even inside of the model ataupun the body itself. Semua temperature dia, we consider it as even, sama. So we can use them ataupun we can predict the temperature of a certain time using transient heat conduction formula, just like here. Okay, next. You can read here why there's epsilon there, because epsilon referring to this curve, because this is the initial temperature. The T infinity here is the environment temperature, because later on, for example, you have some bodies ataupun some copper ball, initial temperature dia lebih kurang minus 5 degree Celsius. So environment temperature dia lebih kurang 30 degree Celsius. So dia akan kembali kepada environment temperature dalam bentuk epsilon graph ni. Epsilon graph. Kalau B1, maksudnya dia akan lambat sedikit lah nak menghampiri ke environment temperature. Kalau dia B2, dia cepat sikit. So B3 dia akan lagi cepat. So what is B? B is referring to time constant here. Time constant. Let me read this statement for you. This equation enable us to determine the temperature or TT of a body at the time of T. At the time of T. Or alternatively, the time T required for the temperature to reach specific value of temperature. Okay, we plugging all the temperature, initial temperature here, environment temperature here, and the time constant, and also the time in second. So we can get that model ataupun that body in that second punya temperature. Okay, the temperature of the body approach the ambient temperature exponentially. That's why kita ada epsilon situ. The temperature of the body changes rapidly at the beginning. Dia akan cepat berubah temperature dia pada awal, dan dia akan slowly begin to similarize the temperature of the environment. Dia lambat lah untuk settling to the environment, tapi at the beginning dia akan cepat. A large value of B indicate that the body approach the environment temperature in a short time. Large value of B, large value of B. Kalau you dapat value of B ni besar, so you can say that it is easy for that model ataupun that body to have a similar temperature of environment temperature. Kan? Kalau contoh dalam soalan nanti, saya ada dua copper ball. So apa yang nak nak didiskuskan ataupun nak dievaluatekan, so you boleh evaluatekan dia punya comparison of B. So what is B? B is those properties. So those properties of B can ascertain you ataupun can be discussed as the bigger B is the closer ataupun the rapid of those body quickly settle to the environment temperature. Okay, macam itulah you try to discuss in term of B. The next slide. So before we use lump system analysis ataupun that formula, we must consider some criteria. Okay, some criteria. So the criteria itself, kalau you cannot meet the criteria, you cannot use this formula. You cannot use this formula. So the criteria that you must meet before subjective to try to solve the problem, you must meet the Biot number less or equal to 0.1. Dia mesti less or 0 or equal to 0.1. The Biot number. What is Biot number? Biot number is the dimensionless number, no dimension. You kalau you plug in the values here, you takkan dapat some dimension lah. So dia hanya number saja. Bila hanya number saja, it will refer to some values there. If it's less than 0.1, so that system is considered as lump system, ataupun that body is considered as lump lump body ataupun lump system. Okay, so the first thing first, you must calculate the characteristic length, of that bodies. Kalau you ada sphere body, you kena kira characteristic length dia lah. Macam mana nak kira characteristic length? You kena ada formula of volume, kemudian you kena ada formula of surface area. Kemudiannya characteristic length tu you includekan dalam Biot number, which is H darab LC divided by K. H is the thermal convection properties, K is conduction, thermal conduction properties. You divide kan dia, you akan dapat some numbers without dimension. So some some numbers without dimension. If the number is bigger than 0.1, you cannot use this system ataupun this formula. If you use, you will suffer error of your calculation. But how much error? You can you can consider it how much error. For example, if your biot number is around 0.5, 0.6, 0.2, we can consider it to use this lump system, because marginally 0.1, around 0.1 to 0.6 or 0.9 marginally is sangat sedikit is compared kalau you dapat biot number dia 4000. So we can, so kita tak boleh compare lah with the real time formula tu dengan lump system tu. Okay, so kalau biot number dia sangat besar, so you cannot use this lump system formula. Later on we will consider another formula, or maybe we will use a graph itself. Okay, but today's session we will only cover on the lump system formula. Okay. So what I said before, if you want to use lump system ataupun lump system formula, you must meet this characteristic of biot number first. If it's meet, so you can proceed to use that lump system formula. If not, you must use different kind of formula. But if you still want to use lump system equation, you will suffer a lot of error. Get a lot of error. If it's still less than 1 marginally to the biot dimensionless number, so there's no problem. You can still use lump system formula. So we can predict easily. For example, like this. You have a spherical copper ball, small body with high thermal conductivity and low convection. The low convection around 15 watt per meter squared degree Celsius. Then the copper ball itself has a K of 401 watt meter degree Celsius, and the diameter is 12 centimeter. So after calculating the characteristic length of that spherical copper ball, we got 0.02. Putting all the biot numbers constant, H, L, C, and K, we get 0.0075 of biot number. So it is applicable to use lump system equation, no problem. So if you use, for example, this is your beef. Beef meat around environment temperature dia ialah around 20 degree Celsius, or dia punya H dia ialah 200 watt per meter square degree Celsius. Dia punya H dia pun dah besar kan. You lihat dekat formula ni, bila H besar, nilai K kecil. Possibly you punya meat tu pun dalam lump system equation. You tak boleh gunakan lump system equation. Dia bukan lump system analysis. So dia tak boleh gunakan lump system. It must use different kind of formula. Okay? So this is easy example. Which model, which body you can use as a lump system model. Okay? So from this bus here, this is easy analogy between heat transfer to a solid and passenger traffic to an island. For example, they try to explain on the transient heat ataupun lump system. Kalau dalam satu island bus, dalam satu island, sebagai contoh Langkawi lah. Kemudahan bas dia tu sangat baik kan. Kemudahan bas tu sangat baik. So bila boat datang, ferry datang, ada beberapa ferry datang, dia boleh turunkan bas tu, dia turunkan passenger dan bas tu tak cram lah kat dalam tu. Kan? So, orang yang turun daripada ferry di jetty tu, dia tak menghadapi cram kat situ. So, we can say that orang tu dia akan distributed evenly dekat whole island. So, we can say that that system is the lump system. Is the lump system. Because no congestion happen. In case kalau dia bukan lump system, what happen? Ada traffic light banyak kat dalam tu. Kemudian bus rosak. For example, ferry datang, passenger tersangkut dekat jetty. So that system is known as lump system. We can say that system is known as lump system. So that is kind of analogy they try to merge on what heat and transfer theory. I don't know whether you understand or not on the analogy itself, but I think it is much easier if you try to figure out why you fry some fish or meat, you try to flip, kan? You try to balikkan dia. Sebab apa? Sebab you punya meat tu bukan satu sistem yang lump. Apa maksud lump? Bukan satu sistem yang bila awak panaskan dia punya skin of your meat ataupun fish, bukan awak panaskan satu fish dia, bukan tiba-tiba dalam dia pun akan terus panas. Kalau dia bukan terus panas, maksudnya dia bukan satu lump system. So they cannot use lump system equation. Okay. Example. Example. I took this example from textbook. Example number 4.1. Temperature measurement by thermocouple. What is thermocouple? Thermocouple ni macam you punya thermometer lah. Tapi dia menggunakan thermometer yang you nampak selalunya ada yang bersentuhan, ada yang tidak bersentuhan. Tapi termometer yang ini ialah termometer bersentuhan, tapi dia dikira ataupun dia dimeasure menggunakan elektronik. Sebab tu kita panggil dia thermocouple. Kalau termometer yang tanpa menggunakan elektronik, dia panggilkan physical thermometer tu lah. Ada merkuri kat dalam ni kan. Tapi bila kita letakkan some electronic in them, so we call it as thermocouple wire. So the problem say like this: the temperature of a gas stream, dia nak measure gas stream gunakan thermocouple, which junction can be approximate diameter of sphere around 1 mm as shown in figure 410. Inilah thermocouple ya. Dekat hujung thermocouple tu ada satu copper yang berdiameter 1 mm. Copper tu sphere lah bentuk dia. The properties of the thermocouple ataupun junction K sini ialah 35 watt meter K Kelvin. Density of that junction ialah 8500 kilogram per meter cube. The CP, constant heat dia, ialah 320 joule kilo G K. K referring to Kelvin, bukannya kilo sini. And the convection heat transfer coefficient of the gas is 210 watt per meter square K. Find ataupun calculate how long it will take for the thermocouple to read 99% of the temperature difference. Okay, dia cakap calculate 99% of the temperature difference. Let me change my pointer, laser pointer, to a pen using color of red there, so I can write my slide. So given in the question is, mana pointer? Given K is K 35 watt meter K, density 8,500 kilogram per meter cube, and the CP is 320 joule kgK, and the H is 210 watt meter square K. Lowercase t. Lowercase t if t here ialah 99%. Okay, 99%. Okay, before we proceed to solve the question, we must try the characteristic of the system first. We must try ataupun we must know what is actually the system is. It is either lump system or a not lump system. If it is a lump system, you can verify it using a Biot numbers, right? So the Biot number is you must try with characteristic length first. LC equal to V divided by surface area, right? So the V for spherical is volume area for spherical is 4 over 3 pi r cos theta, right? So the surface area for spherical is for if I'm not mistaken 4 pi r square. So the characteristic length of your problem here is 4 over 3 pi r cos theta divided by 4 pi r square. Potong r, sini tinggal 1, potong pi 4 atas, boleh buang. So r divided by 3, characteristic length awak ialah r divided by 3. So your l characteristic ataupun you punya diameter given here ialah diameter, but our formula is r, sini 1 mm. So radius dia ialah 0.5 darab 10 cos theta, y kosong 10 cos theta, because this is mm. We need to use SI basic formula, SI basic unit, before we putting any constant in a formula. Any formula, kalau you ada numbers of formula, to avoid confusion, you must putting a basic unit in that formula. Kalau radius ialah unit length, kan? So length basic unit dia ialah meter, bukan millimeter, bukan centimeter, bukan millimeter, bukan densimeter, tapi meter. So you must put a basic formula of radius, lebih kurang 0.5 darab 10 kuasa negatif 3 bahagikan dengan 3. So your LC is, after calculate, your LC is around 1.67 darab 10 power of negative 4 meter. Sebab apa meter saya tahu? Sebab saya tahu length ialah panjang, basic unit dia ialah meter. So saya letak M terus lah. And next, we must calculate Biot. So that we know that system, it is either lump system or not. So the Biot formula is Biot equal to, the formula you don't have to memorize it, because it is all given, even in the test or in the exam. So for the Biot formula, which is equal to H times L LC, referring to characteristic length, divided by K. So H from the equation or from the problem itself is 210, and LC is, where's the pointer, H, 210, characteristic length is 1.67 times 10 power of 4 divided by K. What is my K? I'm not memorize it. 35. So we can get the biot number we can get is, if you press your calculator, you can get the biot number is around 0.001, which is less than 0.1. So we can consider our problem here is the lump system. So if it is lump system, we can use this formula. What is the formula? Tolak T environment divided by T initial minus T environment equal to epsilon minus B lowercase t. So what is B? B is H divided by rho Cp Lc. Cp Lc. Okay? So, kita nak cari T di sini. We want to find T here. Small t there. So, do we have this and this? No, we don't have all this temperature. But we remember that dia bagi ni 99% of TT. What does it mean? That means that if the temperature, initial temperature is initial temperature is zero, Ti is zero, then T infinity is 100. So what is 99%? 99% temperature. What is 99% of temperature? If we want to find 99% of temperature of it, berapa? Kalau T initial dia lah kosong, T environment dia ialah 100. So apakah values, apakah temperature bila dia mencapai 99%? Kan, awak ingat tak graf ni? Graf epsilon tu. Ini temperature awak, environment sebanyak 100 degree Celsius, dan ini adalah T initial awak. Ini adalah epsilon tu. Kita nak tahu berapa 99%. Kat sini berapa 99%? Dari kosong sini 100. Of course dia 99 lah degree dia. Kan? 99 lah degree dia. 99 degree Celsius lah. So we can assume that the TT here is 99 minus 100, 0 minus 100. So this number or this value will yield you value of, if you press calculator, 0.01. Betul? Mestilah betul. Sebenarnya, kalau you tak tahu pun, you boleh tulis macam ni. From the formula, from the question itself, you cakap macam ni kan? To read 99% of initial. Sebenarnya, 1 tolak 99 per 100. equal to 0.01 lah. So that 0.01 is actually the whole of this 0.01. But to make it clearer to you ataupun something later on kalau you nampak dia punya problem dia lebih kurang macam ni, so you can imagine lah macam mana how to solve it. So for this problem, immediately you can write the whole lot here is 0.01. So 0.01 is equal to epsilon minus B T. Kita nak cari T. Minus B berapa? You can find by this formula. Masukkanlah nilai B berapa. B equal to H tadi ialah 210. Rho berapa rho? Rho sini 8500. Sini CP 320. Rho 8500. CP 320. LC 1.67. Darab 10 kuasa negatif 4. Then you can get B. Your B, I'm pressing the calculator just now, got 0.462. Your B is 0.462. So to solve that, 0.01 equal to epsilon negative, don't forget that negative. Student, I will forget that negative. 0.462 T. So how to solve this? You need to find T here. So you need to use ln, right? Normal logarithmic. So ln equal to, bukan ln lah, you times ln on the both side of equation. 0.01 equal to ln epsilon power of 0.4 minus 62 T. So this will remove, right? So ln 0.01 divided by minus 0.462 equal to T. So your T, which is, kalau you press calculator, you can get 9.96 seconds. So 9.96 seconds. Kalau you pakai jam yang ada jarum tu, memang you tak boleh dapat lah 9.96 seconds. You terus dapat 10 seconds kan, cukup nampak 10 seconds. Tapi kalau you pakai yang digital, you boleh dapat 9.96 seconds. Apa maksud time 9.96 seconds? Go back to the example here, or the form, or the question here. Dia cari, dia cakap, calculate berapa masa diperlukan so that the thermocouple read 99% after the initial temperature difference. Okay, berapa 99% selepas initial temperature, berapa masa dia mengambil untuk capai 99% of the initial temperature. Berapa masa? Dia memerlukan masa 9.96 saat. 9.96 saat to reach 99% from the initial temperature. Okay? That is how you can measure the time. Ataupun, for example, dia bagi you time. Berapakah temperature pada 9.96 saat? Berapakah temperature untuk that system selepas 9.96 saat? So, macam mana nak menyelesaikan dia? You kena uji juga menggunakan Biot number. Sama ada dia alarm system ataupun not alarm system. Kalau alarm system, you can immediately using this formula. This formula here. T tolak T infinity divided by T initial tolak T environment. So in the second case tadi, kita dah tahu 9.96 saat. So kita cari T here. Kita kena find lah T berapa. Of course lah, you akan dapat 99 in our case here. Right? That is for the first question. And for the second question itself, berapa minit dah ni? Come on. Tak ada masa pula. Alright. For the second question is a brick. For example, we have a brick of dimension 203 times 102 and times 57 in mm. Be cautious there. In mm, not meter. A brick of course lah. In mm, takkanlah di dalam meter kan. Sama ada di dalam mm ataupun cm. Be cautious that kalau you nak kira volume dengan karakteristik length nanti, student akan banyak silap kat situ. Dia terlupa nak convert to a basic unit sebelum masukkan dalam formula. So a brick has dimension of that is being burned. Tadi dia being cool, ni being burned. Burn hingga 1100 degree Celsius. Kemudian dia allow to cool in room temperature with ambient temperature of 30 degree Celsius. Convection happen around it has a H of 5 watt meter square. Okay, if the brick has the properties of density 1922 and the CP of the brick is 790 and the K of the brick is 0.9, calculate time required to bring the temperature difference of 5 degree Celsius from ambient air temperature. What does it mean? Kita tulis lah satu-satu. Given dimension lah. Kita tulis dimension. Volume. Kita lukis lah senang sikit. Lukisan tak cantik, tak apa. 57 102 di sini 203. Okay, all in mm. Mm. Kemudian dia bagi tahu being burn T initial dia lah. T initial dia ialah 1100 degree Celsius. Kemudian T environment dia ialah 30 degree Celsius. Kemudian H given ialah 5 watt meter square. K. Kemudian density 20 kilogram watt meter cube. CP joule kg K. And the K 0.9. Find time if what does it mean there? Different from ambient temperature is 5 degree Celsius. Kalau ambient dia 30 degree Celsius, kemudian dia nak different of 5 degree Celsius. So kita nak ataupun soalan nak suruh kita cari pada temperature berapa? Pada temperature berapa? Because our equation here it is T tolak T infinity ataupun T environment divided by T initial tolak T environment equal to epsilon power of minus B times T. Dia suruh cari lowercase t. Tapi kita dah tahu T environment kita dah tahu, T initial pun kita tahu, tapi T here temperature pada time tu kita tak tahu lagi. Temperature pada time tersebut kita tak tahu lagi. Cuma yang dia bagi tahu ialah di sini difference from air temperature, ambient air temperature. Sebenarnya senang saja. Ambient temperature dibagi 30. Kemudian different from air temperature ialah 5 degree. So possibly 35 lah, kan? Betul tak? 35 tetap tolak 30 degree, tak dapat 5 degree, kan? So you punya TT here ialah 35 lah, 35 degree Celsius. Then find lowercase t. Lowercase t ni saat lah, dia tak dalam minit. Sebab semuanya kita masukkan dalam basic unit. Bila masukkan basic unit dalam formula, semuanya then final answer kita mesti dalam saat lah. Dia tak mungkin dalam minit, dia tak mungkin dalam jam. So bear in mind lah, kalau mm kat sini pun you tak tukar kepada basic unit, dan kalau kat sini dibagi dalam kilowatt, you tak tukar dia dalam watt, so you takkan dapat T dalam saat. Okay, so make sure the basic unit of every constant before plugging the value inside the formula. Make sure that is the first thing first. You need to cautions before calculating any problem atau before solving any problem. So for this sample, yeah, to solve that we must test using Biot numbers. So to solve for Biot numbers, we must calculate the LC first, characteristic length. What is the characteristic length formula? Volume divided by surface area. So the volume of the brick, how to calculate the volume of the brick? Ni memang tak ada formula. You kena tahu sendirilah, sebab saya rasa kira volume ni sekolah rendah kot, dia bukan sekolah menengah. So how to find the volume? 203 dibagi kita dimension kan di sini kan. Ni 203 dalam unit m meter, kita kena convert dia siap-siap ke sini, times 102 10 power of 3. Kalau saya darab 10 power of 3 tu, maksudnya saya nak convert dia kepada unit meter. Okey, dari mm nak convert ke meter, terus tulis time 10 power of minus 3 lah. Kemudian times 57 power of minus 3. Then you can get volume divided by surface area of the brick. How to find the surface area of the brick? Macam ni kan brick awak kan. Untuk surface ni dia ada 2. So 2 times 102 times 57 meter. Okay, plus 2 yang atas ni pula, kan, atas dan bawah kan. So atas dan bawah ialah 203 times 102. 203 negatif 3 times 102 negatif 3. Another one, belakang dan depan sudah, kiri dan kanan belum. So 57 minus 3 times 203 minus 3. So you will get characteristic length of, saya baru buat tadi soalan ni, characteristic length of 0.0015 meter. Macam mana saya tahu meter? Sebab length unit panjang. Panjang basic unit dia ialah meter, bukan sentimeter, bukan kilometer, bukan sentimeter, tapi meter. So saya bila saya make sure every unit saya masukkan sini ialah exactly basic unit, so saya akan dapat answer dalam basic unit juga, meter. Okay, sebab ini semua tak ada masalah lah. Dia hanya dekat characteristic length ni, semuanya unit dia meter ni memang tak ada masalah lah. But once you ada involve of kilowatt, macam mana you tak convert dia dalam basic unit, you akan pening nanti. So make sure in every type of ataupun every courses, kalau you nampak formula, make sure basic unit you kena plug in inside there. So the answer there, kalau you tahu di dalam power for example, dia mesti dalam basic unit of power. Basic unit of power apa? Watt. Dia bukan kilowatt, dia bukan megawatt, dia watt. Okay. Kalau masa, basic unit dia ialah second. Kalau berat, basic unit dia ialah kilogram. Kalau temperature, basic unit dia ialah degree Celsius. It can be Kelvin. Okay. And then we can test for Biot number. So the Biot number formula is equal to H times LC divided by K. So your H here, 5 LC 0.015. Your K is 0.9. So what is your Biot number? Your Biot number, saya tekan dulu, saya tak tekan lagi tadi. Biot number ialah 5 darab 0.015 divided by 0.9. So you punya biot numbernya di sini ialah 0.08. Can this is still 0. Below than 0.1. So that system ataupun brick ni kita boleh consider it as a lump system. So bila dia lump system, what we can do with lump system, we can use this formula T infinity Ti minus T infinity epsilon power of B times T. You nampak macam saya memorize kan? Memang saya memorize pun. Last time saya belajar benda ni ialah pada tahun 2004. Saya boleh ingat lagi sampai sekarang. Why not you orang muda-muda patutnya boleh ingat lah. Tapi in your case, you tak perlu ingat pun formula. Biasalah budak-muda sekarang kan, susah nak ingat formula. Saya bagi you formula. Even you can write your formula, your own formula dalam piece of paper dalam exam nanti. You boleh bawa piece of paper tu. So we need to find T. So what is B? B is H rho C P L C. Okay, kita tulis, kita find B dulu. B is, saya tak ingat below of H, 5 dan T 1920 CP tak ingat, 790 our LC is tadi apa, alamak tak ingat lah, 0.08, 0.08. So our B is B here is not Biot number, but B is a time constant ataupun unit dia ialah S second inverse. Okay, so saya pressing calculator, saya tak sempat habis kira tadi. 1920 darab 790 darab 0.08, itu punya jawapan ialah 412 darab 10 kuasa -5 second inverse. Okay, so dia suruh cari T kat sini. Kita tahu TT tadi 35 tolak T environment 30, T initial berapa? 1100 tolak 30 epsilon minus 4.12 darab 10 -5 T. Find lowercase T. So ini you settlekan dulu. Normal logarithmic 5/1070 kan equal to minus 4.12 power of minus 5 T. So you punya T, you tekan calculator, akan dapat 5 divided by 10^30 minus 5 36. So T kat sini ialah minus 5, saya tekan calculator sebab saya tak habis kira lagi tadi, power of 5 divided by answer. Sekejap, 4.12 power of 5 minus 5 divided by 5.36. So you punya answer will be around 7.6865. Wait a second, saya salah buat, bukan tu. Sepatutnya patutlah tak masuk lakar. Patutnya ialah minus 5.36 divided by minus 4.12 minus 5 equal to T. Kan? Terbalik ni. Ni terbalik ni salah. Ni terbalik. So, your T is, kalau you press calculator, baru dah nampak logik sikit. Minus 5.36 divided by minus 4.12 power of minus 5 around 1300.0087.874 saat. Ni yang saya buat lah. Ni yang saya buat. You can recheck back because there's no double check here, because I'm just solve it during the class. You can double check. If I'm press it calculator wrongly, you can double check. It may be wrong, it may be right here. If it is wrong, you can correct by your own. If it is correct, alhamdulillah. So that is for lump system. We will continue on the transient heat conduction in large plane walls, long cylinder and sphere with special effects. This will cover in class. I will cover it in class because we have done it in online, because it is really suffer me. I'm suffer a lot to write it on this small pad to show you how the calculation works. So we will cover this on the class. Hope that next week I can see you in physical. On the Monday, we will do some more lump system problem tutorial, which is physical too. See you there for this session. That's it. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh.